Yes, så er vi klar til at gå i gang, og så vil jeg egentlig bare på vegne af i-Centrum, Victor og jeg selv, byde jer rigtig varmt velkommen. Victor kommer fra en af vores centrale App Store-partner, i-Centrum, og jeg selv er direktør her for SuperOffice Danmark. Så lad os kaste os over det. Først og fremmest, så vil jeg lige sætte et par ord på kunderejsen, fordi det er sådan, at alt, hvad vi beskæftiger os med her på SuperOffice, det relaterer sig til kunderejsen. Og det vil sige, hvad er det egentlig for en oplevelse, I giver jeres kunder i deres rejse gennem jeres butik? Og det er helt fra, at jeres kunder ikke ved, at de har et behov for jeres ydelser, for jeres produkter herude i den grå out-of-market-fase, til de bliver ved med at købe jeres produkter, jeres ydelser, som engangskøb eller som abonnementer, herover i den lysegrønne loyalty-fase. Og jeg ved, at der sidder et par stykker på webinaret her i dag, som har hørt mig tale om kunderejsen på andre webinarer, som har haft et andet fokus. Og når jeg bliver ved med at vende tilbage til kunderejsen, så er det fordi, at det i min optik er en utrolig god måde at anskue og udfordre sin virksomhed på, om der kunne ligge et uindfriet digitaliseringspotentiale i et eller flere af de kontaktpunkter, som jeres kunderejse består af, og som I kan se her. Det kunne for eksempel være, tracker vi, hvem der åbner hvilke artikler, som vi har lagt ud på SoMe, og opretter vi en call to action, så der automatisk bliver fulgt op hos kunderne her i den lyseblå initial brand recognition fase. Og går vi videre i den active evaluation fase, anvender vi så her for eksempel webforms for at gøre det lettere for et lead at vurdere, hvad det egentlig er for en værdi, I kan tilføre kunden. Eller bruger I chat til hurtigt at besvare nysgerrige spørgsmål, så de spørgsmål ikke bliver besvaret af en konkurrent i stedet for. Og de webforms og de chat-sessioner, som jo er kontaktpunkter, bliver de automatisk journaliseret direkte ned i jeres SuperOffice, så den data, information, den lige pludselig bliver gjort til tilgængelig viden for jeres kolleger, som de kan handle på. Og går vi videre i purchase, i købsfasen, i den mørkeblå fase, har I så her for eksempel en ERP-integration, som minimerer dobbeltarbejde, og som automatisk sikrer valid og opdateret data. Og kører vi videre over i den grønne fase, når et lead så er blevet til kunden, og de skal til at opleve, hvordan er det at være kunde i jeres butik, har I så en god og automatisk måde at sikre en proaktiv adfærd, når de har brug for hjælp. Det kunne være FAQ'er, det kunne være inde på en kundeportal. Og har I en god måde at sikre en proaktiv adfærd, når vedligeholdelsesaftaler og abonnementer skal fornyes. Og nøgleordet i alt, hvad jeg har sagt her, det er automatisering. Automatisering, som bliver gjort muligt, fordi vi har digitaliseret et kontaktpunkt. Vi har sat strøm på noget data i kontaktpunktet, og derfor så kan den arbejdsproces, der anvender dataen, automatiseres. Det er smart. Det sparer tid, det sparer penge, det minimerer fejl, og det sikrer, at ting rent faktisk sker. Og sidst men ikke mindst, kan det efterlade et langt mere professionelt indtryk over for jeres kunde. Det vil sige, at de får en bedre kunderejseoplevelse. Og det er jo blandt andet det, der er målet med jeres SuperOffice-løsning. Så på dagens webinar, der sætter vi fokus herover i den grønne del af kunderejsen i loyalty-fasen, fordi det er et faktum, at det er langt mere omkostningseffektivt at sælge mere til eksisterende kunder, end det er at sælge til nye kunder. Og de af jer, som lytter med her i dag, I har helt sikkert både aftaler og kontrakter med jeres kunder. Og så har I måske også konstateret, at hvis man har flere kontrakttyper, eller man har mange kontrakter, så kan det faktisk være svært at bevare overblikket over, hvilke kunder man skal følge op på og når. Og med den her nye Contract Manager app fra i-Centrum, så får man altså automatisk opfølgninger ind i sin kalender, så man husker at genforhandle kontrakter, der udløber i tide. Så jeg kunne passende spørge her, om der sidder nogen herude lige nu, som synes, de har et nemt overblik over, hvilke af jeres kontrakter, der udløber i år. Og hvis ikke I har det, så har Victor i hvert fald fra i-Centrum en interessant løsning, som han vil dele med jer her. Så mens vi lige får mulighed for at give stafetten videre til i-Centrum, og Victor får mulighed for at dele sin præsentation, så vil jeg sige, we'll now switch into English. Victor comes from Sweden, and we think it It's better for both parties is if Victor can conduct his presentation in Swedish, in English. So over to you, Victor.
Hi, thank you so much, Pernilla, and thank you all for being here this morning. I will be showing you today the Contract Manager, which is basically the latest app out of the i-Centrum kitchen. A quick agenda for this webinar, which I have an intention that I will run for about 20 to 25 minutes. So I'm not going to keep you too long because it's a very simple app, and I'm hoping that you know we can generate some questions and answers that we can put the remaining time of this webinar into. So first, I'm going to give you a quick introduction of myself and i-Centrum. I'm going to run us through what the Contract Manager is and what the areas of use are before we then jump into how to use it. How do we set it up to make sure that it's relevant for your particular business? How do we then create new contracts? And how do we keep track of them? How do we filter and find the ones that are actually relevant that you want to see? I will then talk about the pricing if you wish to move forward with it, and then we will have a short questions and answers once we're done. Myself, my name is Victor. I work at i-Centrum, where I hold the position of head of sales. And I generally work more with our apps that you know work with SuperOffice processes. And I also work a lot with our integrations. i-Centrum is a preferred partner in Sweden, and we work a lot in lockstep with SuperOffice to help improve the customer journey for all SuperOffice customers, with a focus, of course, on the App Store. So what is the Contract Manager? Where does it come from? Basically, it is a tool to create and manage time-sensitive processes within SuperOffice. Now, notice I don't use the word contract specifically, but it's more time-sensitive processes, things that have an end that may need to be renewed or terminated, something that you have to take action on at a certain point in time. Now, it's not necessarily only current contracts that you have in place. The whole idea of the Contract Manager is to help you also keep track of past contracts that have been that you might need to follow up on, or future processes that might be that you might want to help yourself keep track of. The whole idea being we want to generate automatic activities in the calendar for you to be able to follow up on. What it is, in short, is a container on the company in SuperOffice where we can then store all information regarding these types of processes. All the sales that are relevant to it, the documentation that is relevant to it, the start and end dates, of course, for when you need to be able to renew, and any statuses and such. Moving forward, the types of contracts that we then speak of, the areas of use. I mean, the most common thing that we think of is, of course, sales contracts. A lot of our customers, ourselves included, you know, we work with a subscription-based organization. We sell licenses that after a year, they need to be renewed. It's important for us to keep track of when the date is for this to happen, if they're terminating and that type of thing. It's also a very powerful tool to keep track of our competitor contract, for example. If I want to know, you know, I'm pitching a certain customer, they're signed with somebody else that runs out on a certain date, I can use the Contract Manager to create an automatic update for myself to know this is the day that I should contact them again because I know that the competitor contract is running out. It also works for things like procurement or purchasing. You know, if we have GDPR agreements in place, NDAs or SLAs, all of these things are, to some extent, they have a time-based limit and you need to keep track of it. I actually had an interesting meeting with a big lock company in Sweden just yesterday who said as well, like, wait, you know what? Public procurements, I want to know when that is actually due so that I can then put reminders in place for when I need to take certain actions in order to be ready for the end date of this public procurement. So that's just another use case that I found very, very interesting, where we can then, you know, broaden the scope of the Contract Manager, not to just include the sales that are in place today. And if you have terminated a contract with a customer and you want to follow up, say a year later, you can also store this information in Contract Manager. A year from now, you will have that automatic reminder in SuperOffice saying, now it's time to contact them again. So basically, the whole idea of the Contract Manager is any type of business activity that has an end date that is set to renew, you can use this app for. So how do we customize it? First of all, before I show you how we make a contract, I want to show you how we can set this up, because as with everything, there is no such thing as a one size fits all. It's built mostly on standard SuperOffice information, which is, you know, that's why it's so easy to get up and running and why it works in such a good complement to the SuperOffice. But in some cases, you know, that is not enough. You need to have some certain user-defined fields, other types of input information that is relevant to the contract for you to see the real value of it. So we've created basically a small design phase, if you will, where an administrator can go in, and from here, you can then set up the different types of contracts that are relevant to you. You know, for us, for example, we might want to keep track of competition for the subscriptions or services, but here you can also very easily create the ones that are relevant for you. On the side as well, the different statuses that might be relevant for you, you know, we cannot go in and decide this is how your business should be run. That we leave up to you. So we make it very easy for you to customize and design the app so that it becomes valuable. From there, we can then create these extra fields. Basically, this is, it's an open book for you. So if it's a product that you want to link to the particular contract, if it's volume or discounts, or if there's a service level agreement in place, all of these things you can go in and customize so that when the contract is created, the correct information is stored and easy to find for you and everyone within your organization. In terms of users, you know, we follow the same process that we do with all our apps. You're not limited, or depending on the amount of SuperOffice users you have, you don't have to buy the same amount of licenses to the contract managers. You set this up on your own. And more importantly, getting set up might be, you know, it might seem like a long process if you already have a lot of contracts in place to go in and create things one by one. So we can actually provide you with an Excel template where you can fill in all the information, import this directly into SuperOffice, and then you're up and running. So it's a very simple process. So how do we then create these contracts once we're up and designed how we want to have it? It's a simple web panel that we have both on the company card and on the sales card in SuperOffice. What I'm showing you here is just the clean slate, if you will, that you're met with once you start up the contract manager. From there, you can hit the new contract. And what we have then is a simple form that you need to fill out. So I'm gonna show you in the next step sort of the different information fields that I'm gonna walk you through the different information fields. But the reason I have this up here is because from the design phase, the different types of contracts that we have and the statuses are simple drill down menus now that you can then choose which is the one that's relevant for this particular contract. So as we fill this out, you know, we can set a name for the contract, making it easy to find. We define the type of contract that it is, who is responsible for it within your organization, the status of this contract, who's the contact at the customer side. We can connect any sale to this contract as well. And this becomes very relevant in a lot of cases, because let's take an example. I'm selling a 3-year contract that is billed on a yearly basis. I then need to set up 3 separate sales to be contained within this contract. And they can be of different value. It doesn't really matter. But it's very easy to connect the sales of SuperOffice to the contract itself. The price is the value of the contract, naturally. We can define the payment period, which then becomes obviously important if we're going to set up a series of billing to keep track of that. If we want to add a description, super simple. If there are any special terms, we're able to add this. The start and the end date, we define using obviously the SuperOffice calendar, and it's using these dates that we then are able to generate the automatic reminders to automate the process of keeping track of what it is that I actually need to do. How long does the contract run? How much notice are we giving the customer before, for example, the contract is set to renew or expire? And if we do extend it, how long is that extension going to be? The reminders, which are tied to the end date, are what then generates the automatic activities in SuperOffice. And if you have notifications on in SuperOffice, these are going to go bing when the time is right. Then we get on basically to finish it off. The extra fields, we can then define whatever information it is that we want. And we're also able to attach any relevant documentation that is, you know, for this contract. For us, for example, we use GetAccept, which, you know, before we send out a quote, we get that signed, that's stored in SuperOffice. We can then very quickly just attach this using SuperOffice or upload from anywhere else. So it's very, very straightforward. It's a simple form for you to use to input all the relevant information. Once that is done, you'll see now that the contract manager web panel has a contract stored for this particular company. And if you click on this little menu button, we'll now see that there is a it's expanded, and all the information that is relevant for this particular process is stored in a very simple, easy to read manner, where anyone within your organization can go in and actually see what is the important information regarding this particular contract. Very straightforward. And as you can see here, there are automatically generated reminders that will be stored for i-Centrum that, you know, on the, as this contract was set to expire on a certain date, a month before, you'll have a reminder generated a week before, all according to how you've set it up yourself. We've even created a separate contract reminder type just to once again make it as simple and as easy to follow as possible. So then the question becomes, okay, so once I've set all of this up, I want to, in a simple manner, also be able to find the contracts that are relevant, you know, sort them in a way on an organizational level. Now, SuperOffice obviously has their selections menu, but we've run into a small, you know, design snag, if you will, on this point, because for a company could have multiple contracts stored within itself, and using selections, we need to store this information in a clever manner on the more fields. So because there are multiple contracts that can be connected to a certain company, we've actually built our own filter function that is within SuperOffice that makes it easier to then be able to go in and find multiple contracts that are actually connected to one company. So this is what it looks like from here. So depending on the information that you want to filter on, we've built a search function that is very dynamic and easy to use that will then help us pull out the relevant information. So let's say I'm in a situation where I want to find all the contracts that end, you know, in January 2022. And I want to, you know, find the ones that have there are year-long contracts with a three-month notice. So once I put this into, you know, the search function, the contract manager is then going to pull all the results based on the information that I'm searching for. So once again, even if you have user-defined fields or anything along those lines, this feature will easily help you to find the contracts that are relevant for any particular parameters that you're searching for. And basically, that is how easy the contract manager is. I mean, there's not a lot to it. What we've tried to create is just a very simple, intuitive web panel where, based on the information that SuperOffice is able to store, we've just reprogrammed it a little bit to display in a simpler fashion, but also to give you then the opportunity to actually have the system provide the automated reminders, as opposed to you having to keep track of everything yourself. For those that are interested in, you know, moving forward with this, the pricing structure is very simple as well. It's a tiered pricing structure, so depending on how many you are, it actually gets cheaper. I've provided the information in euros because I think it's easier for you to compare it as opposed to Swedish crowns. We will be having a Danish price list as well, but this gives you a good idea of the costs, basically. It doesn't matter if you're online or on-site. The only requirement that we have is for the on-site customers that you have SuperOffice 8.5 or later. But we are able to install this on a solution as well. And that's really it. I mean, I've tried to make this as short and as simple as possible because I don't want to overcomplicate a tool that is already very, very simple. So, Pernilla, do we have any questions that have popped up in the chat up until now?
No, not yet. But any questions are still very welcome. So let's just give people a couple of minutes. While we do that, I think we should finish off. And thank you, Vita, for your presentation here. Being proactive via automation, I think, is something that makes perfect sense. So you can obviously all reach out to both Victor and myself in case you have any follow-up questions. I think we will conclude the seminar with this and stop the recording. And then I just think we'll want to want to wish everybody a very nice day. The sun is shining here in Denmark, at least, so enjoy it. And thank you very much for taking the time to listen in today. Thank you.
Thank you all so much. And if anyone does have, you know, any further questions, we're always open to have a more one-on-one type of demonstration with you, where we can look more specifically at your organization, your processes, and your needs, and from there, kind of mold the solution around the expectations that you have as well.